अच्छा हाँ हाँ ठीक है ठीक है ठीक है में से कोई एरिसेंट में भी जॉब करता है? एरिसेंट एरिसेंट में कोई वर्क करता है? कौन सी टीम में?
सोर्स वाइल।
ओके, जो अभी मर्ज हुई है? नहीं, आई थिंक होगी अभी। आपकी फायरवॉल टीम मर्ज होने वाली है ना सोर्स फायर के साथ? Yep, right now you have a dedicated team because the Cisco is going to do what? Ericent is going to merge your team with firewall. Sure, login.
But if you configure the login, then only.
Yep, then only it is going to work.
But what is the default login delay?
There is no default login delay, because that concept is going to work with iOS login enhancement. If your iOS login enhancement is not there, it is not going to work.
Auto secure command. Is there any command? It is not working.
This one, it's a command that is going to provide basic security to the box. It's more like it's an interactive dialog box. It's more like you are doing some auto configuration. जैसे आप जब router को initially stage पे आते हैं तो he asks like, do you need? Do you need an? जैसे आप किसी router का access लेते हो. So not this one, but if you're going to take it, it's going to say you want auto dialog box to fill up all the IP addresses and everything, same like auto secure. It's an initial command that has been developed to provide basic level of security, like do you want to configure ACL, do you want to enable secret password, what will be the secret password, that is called auto secure. See, auto secure configuration enhance the security of the router. So it's more like, rather than remembering all the security concepts, you can run the command auto secure. And he's going to ask you all the options that, okay, now this is the time to configure this or that, something like this. So we were discussing about ACS. So this will be my server. This will be 12.1.2. This will be 192.168.1.1. And 192.168.1.50. Change कर देता हूँ मैं साथ के साथ ही. ACS. Okay, and this will be my client. So I will call it R2 as my what? AAA client, right? So this will become what? AAA client, and this will be my AAA server. Okay, so let's configure the IP addressing. So on R1 I have to say what? 12.1. No shut. On R2 I am going to say interface F0/0, IP address 12.1.2. No shut. And on F0 by 1, I'm going to say 192.168.1.1. No, shut. Let me enable my ACS. And magnifier, the command to check the IP address is show interface gigabit 0, and right now the IP address on the box is 192.168.1.50. to check whether all the applications are running or not, show application status. ACS. So all the applications are in running. Okay, no issues. So this means I can ping the box CMD ping 192.168.1.50. Yep, I can ping it. Let me ping it from my router so that the router is reachable to the ACS server or not. So ping 50. Yep, I can ping it. The last step is to take the GUI of the box. So let's take the GUI Internet Explorer. HTTPS 192.168.1.50. So till then is going to take some time. Let's configure the CLI commands. The first command is what? AAA? New mod. The second command. Let's create named method list, not default. Let's create each and every named method list. AAA authentication login. My auth group techx. Next command. AAA authorization. Exec my exec group. Next, AAA authorization commands. Zero, let's give it my command group techx plus. That is for one, and is for 15. Then the next step, we have to call on the line VTY. So line VTY 0 to 4, login, authentication, my auth, then exec, my exec, authorization commands 0, my commands 1, and the last one is? Then the last step is to define the techx server. 1.50 key is what? Cisco. Do show history. This is my complete configuration. If you have any doubt, you can ask regarding this point. To enable the service, we are going to say AAA new mod. This will enable the AAA service. The next step, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to create a rule for authentication, like authentication, authorization, accounting. Apart from that, I want to use which process? Authentication process. When someone try to log in, and then I use the concept of named method list. Named means that I have to apply on any one of the lines. So I'm going to line VTY 0 to 4, login, authentication, my auth. Same with the authorization, that when someone try to access the box, I have to give him a certain privilege level. That information will be forwarded to TechX Plus. He's going to tell you which privilege level you should assign. What particular command the user can run? So these are the this thing. Now let's go to the TechX server. So ACS admin, and by default the password is default. He's going to ask to reset. So default. Yep, I got the access. Network resources, where I'm going to define the AAA clients, right? User and identity stores, where I'm going to create username and passwords. Policy elements, where I'm going to define privilege plus command set. Access policy, where I'm going to create what? Rules. So let's start one by one. So I'm going to click on the network resources, and I'm going to click on AAA clients. Click on it, and here you are going to find you don't have any kind of AAA client till now. So what you are going to do is you are going to say create, and he's asking a name. So the name is, I'm going to say R2. You can define any name, it is just a logical name. So you can define anything. I can say router 2, whatever you want to define. The IP address 192.168.1.1. And the next thing you are going to define is what? Protocol. Which protocol you are going to use? So this is the option. Authentication option, either TechX Plus or Radius. So I'm going to say I want to use TechX Plus. And the password is Cisco. Submit. So I have created a database with the name of, spelling galat ho gayi, theek hai, router 2 192.168.1.1. This is the IP address of the router, and the protocol I am going to use is TechX Plus. So this is the scope of network resources. The next scope is to create a username and password. Before that, let me tell you what will be our configuration. We are going to do what? We are going to create two users. I'm going to create two groups. The first group name is fresher. The second group name is roots. In the fresher, I have a user ABC. In the root, I have a user of XYZ. So this is the name of the group. This is group name. This is username. Then what privilege level I need to assign? So I want to assign him privilege level 1, and then I want to assign him privilege level 10. I want to assign him privilege level 1, and then I want to assign him 15. Now the question is, how 1 to 10? See, as soon as you are going to log in, I want to make sure you are going to land on privilege level 1. But when you are going to define any kind of enable password, you will be shifted to privilege level 10. So after enable authentication, I want to make sure you are going to land on privilege level 10. Dekho, aap pehle kis mein the? Privilege level 1 mein. Show privilege. You are in privilege level 1. But after typing enable password, right now I don't have any enable password, but after typing the enable password, you will be landing privilege level 50. Same here, but I want to make sure when the user will log in, he's going to land on 1. But after typing the enable password, I have to make sure he's going to land on privilege level 10. And in this case, 1 and then 15. So this is the privilege level. Then the next step is what? Command sets. What particular command the user can run? So I'm going to make sure he can run all the show commands, except I don't want him to run show IP interface brief. Okay. Plus I don't want that he can run comma. I don't want that he can run router EIGRP. The commands he can run is show commands, plus he can run config terminal, plus he can run router OSPF. So this is the configuration from the perspective of fresher. So this is the configuration from the perspective of fresher. So I want to allocate all these parameters to fresher. For the root user, I want to allow him all the commands. So he will be able to run all the commands. So root user will be able to run all the commands. So this configuration, this group will be created. The group and the username will be created in identities. The privilege level and command set will be created in policy element. And I'm going to bind all these things in the access control policy. So first create a group. Fresher and root. So I will go to this one. I will say user and identity stores. Identity groups. I want to create two group. Create one group is root. Another group is fresher. So I have successfully created two groups, group 1 fresher, group 2 root. What is the next step? To create a username and password. So username ABC belongs to what? Fresher. So I have to create ABC that belongs to fresher. So users create ABC. Identity group. This ABC belongs to fresher. Okay, ABC belongs to fresher. Password. Let's give it ABC123. ABC123. So the password is ABC123. The next thing I have to define what? I have an option of enable password. Agla kya option hai? So let's define the enable password. Let's make it enable. Enable. This is a password that is enable only. Ek password bana diya maine enable. Because he has to type enable keyword, right? Then only he will shift from privilege level 1 to privilege level 10. So the password is enable. Submit. नहीं बट बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस यही कहते हैं कि आपको डायरेक्टली प्रिविलेज लेवल 10 से अच्छा है कि आप उसको ऑथेंटिकेट कराओ 1 से 10 के लिए. आपकी मर्जी, आप डायरेक्टली उसको किस पे ले आओ 10 पे. कहाँ पे? क्रिएट यहाँ पे क्या ये एक्चुअली क्या होता है कि आप इट्स अप टू यू कि आप यूजर नेम पासवर्ड कहाँ से लेना चाहते हो. इंटरनल यूजर मतलब है विद इन द बॉक्स. हाँ इंटरनल मतलब बॉक्स के अंदर. अगर आप नहीं चाहते कि नहीं नहीं मुझे नहीं चाहिए मेरे एडी सर्वर पे यूज़र कॉन्फिगर्ड है तो आप यहाँ से कॉन्फिगरेशन करोगे एल डैप की. इंटरनल यूजर्स मतलब दैट दिस इंफॉर्मेशन विल बी स्टोर्ड लोकली टू द बॉक्स. और यूजर्स क्यों आ रहा है इंटरनल तो मतलब विद इन द बॉक्स. यूजर क्यों आ रहा है क्योंकि आप आइडेंटिटी दो टाइप से बना सकते हो यूजर्स एंड होस्ट. होस्ट मतलब आई वॉन्ट टू ऑथेंटिकेट ए प्रिंटर मतलब मेरे नेटवर्क में सिर्फ यही प्रिंटर आ सके और कोई ना आ सके बिकॉज मैंने आपको बताया था नेटवर्क सर्विसेज राइट. सो आई कैन ऑथेंटिकेट द यूजर्स और द मशीन्स. अब प्रिंटर तो यूजर नेम पासवर्ड नहीं डाल सकता सो इन दैट केस आई एम गोइंग टू डिफाइन व्हाट होस्ट. यहाँ पे मैं यूजर्स बना रहा हूँ इसलिए लिखा रहा है इंटरनल यूजर्स क्योंकि जो डेटाबेस बनेगा लोकली ऑल्सो इट इज डिवाइडेड इंटू टू पार्ट्स इंटरनल होस्ट एंड इंटरनल यूजर्स. इंटरनल मतलब विद इन द बॉक्स एंड यूजर इज दैट इट कंटेन्स यूजर नेम एंड पासवर्ड. होस्ट मीन्स इट कंटेन्स ओनली द मैक एड्रेस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर आप होस्ट पे जाओगे क्रिएट यू आर गोइंग टू सी ओनली डिफाइन द मैक एड्रेस और यहां पे आप डिफाइन कर रहे हो यूजर नेम एंड पासवर्ड. तो एक पासवर्ड और बनाना हमें यूजर नेम पासवर्ड एक्स वाई जेड एंड द ग्रुप ही बिलोंग्स इज रूट. XYZ 123 enable let's define enable only enable. ठीक है so I have defined two users username ABC which belongs to the group fresher XYZ which belongs to the root. The next step is to go to policy elements. In the policy element, I am going to define device administration. मैंने आपको कल भी बताया था AAA deployment दो तरीके से होता है device administration and network services या network access. यहाँ पे मैं बात किसी कर रहा हूँ device because in device I will get a option of privilege level that is called shell and command set that what particular command the user can run. So I am going to click on shell create. And here I will say fresher shell privilege level बना रहा हूँ. तो I'm going to say common task default privilege. Default privilege means when the user will log in successfully I want to land him on privilege level 1. Fresher सबसे पहले किस में जाएगा privilege level 1 में. And the maximum keyword means whenever he's going to type the enable password which privilege level you want to assign. So I want to assign him privilege level. अगर आपको enable authentication नहीं कराना just define 10. User login करे तो भी 10 में रहे और maximum किस में रहे 10 में. But if you want to use enable concept also you can say 1 और जब वो enable define करे तो वो किस में आ जाए 10 में. बहुत चीज़ें push करा सकते हो आप धीरे धीरे देखेंगे जैसे टाइम ACL क्या क्या एक्सेस कर सके टाइम आउट कितनी देर के लिए आइडल टाइम आउट. ये ओवरऑल टाइम आउट है कि 5 मिनट तक ही सेशन रहेगा और आइडल मीन्स कि इफ ही सिटिंग आइडल इज नॉट डूइंग एनीथिंग आई वांट टू परफॉर्म रीसेट सबमिट. और एक क्या बनानी है रूट शेल कॉमन टास्क. द टास्क दैट आई वांट टू परफॉर्म इज डिफॉल्ट प्रिविलेज 1 एंड मैक्सिमम प्रिविलेज 15. And submit. So I have two privileges. I haven't bind those privileges with the users. I just created those privileges. Fresher के अंदर कुछ भी नहीं है. सिर्फ क्या है? एक privilege. 1 and 10. And in the root, I have what? Just a privilege level 1 and 15. I haven't bind that ABC belongs to this one or that thing. No. I have just created privilege. Now I have to create command. create. And now I'm going to create a command set for a fresher. And this is how you are going to define the commands. Here the inheritance rule doesn't work. Whatever the you have learned, here it is not going to work. So the task is to make sure he can run all the show commands except show IP interface brief. So I'm going to say show. Argument mai define nahi kara, this means he can run all the show commands, add. But there is a condition, he cannot run what? Show IP interface brief. So show IP interface brief. I'm going to say rather than permit, I want to deny, and the deny is show IP interface brief. So permit show commands, deny show IP interface brief. The next thing I said is the user, I have to make sure the user can run OSPF but not EIGRP. So I'm going to say configure terminal, and you make sure you are good in spelling, because if you are going to type something like this, this is not a command, right? And you are going to click add, he's going to add that command. He's not going to verify whether the command is valid or not. When the request will come, he will match the request with this command set. If it is match, he will define the action. If it is not going to match, I have a implicit deny. That if a command that is configure terminal, you are sending a command that is configure terminal. So he's going to try to match with the first command set. It is not going to match, because the first command set is what? The first command set is what? Show. Config terminal is say to match nahi hogi, right? He's going to drop it. Next, show IP interface brief. No. Next, CONFIRE. But the user is typing CONFIGURE. It is not matching with this one. So at the end of the day, deny all. So in the lab also, make sure you are going to type the command right. And if you are not sure about it, do one thing. Use the help of this thing. Configure terminal. Because he's not going to tell you whether your command is correct or not. He will just accept the command. This command is not logical. CONFRE. But he's going to accept it. So in the lab also, don't be in hurry. Make sure you are going to verify each and every command. So let me delete it because this is not the command. And let's say configure terminal. Add. Next command the user can run is router OSPF. हाँ मतलब अगर आपकी कमांड मैच नहीं होगी, अगर सपोज आपने जो कमांड चाहिए वो मैच हो गई, और अगर जो कमांड नहीं चाहिए थी, आपने सपोज राउटर या एजीआरपी चलाने की कोशिश की, एट द एंड ऑफ द डे अगर इसमें नहीं है तो वो क्या कर देगा? नहीं 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 ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. अगर आपने इट्स नॉट लाइक दिस कि वो पहले कॉन्फ़िगर टर्मिनल ही है, ये है जो आप अनसीक्वेंस ऑर्डर में भी आप डिफाइन कर सकते हो कि पहले राउटर ओएसपीएफ दे दो फिर कॉन्फ़िगर टर्मिनल दे दो, ऐसा कोई इशू नहीं है. एंड आई डोंट वॉन्ट हिम टू रन, देखो वैसे डिनाई स्टेटमेंट डिफाइन करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है, because there will be a what? Implicit deny. But this is mandatory because show commands are allowed, right? But you have denied show IP interface brief, so you have to specify that I want to deny this thing. Submit. So this is fresher command set. Create. Ab mujhe kya banana hai? Root. And the task of the root is to he can run all the commands. Ab raat bhar yahan pe baith ke commands to define nahi kar sakte. So I have a option. Permit any command that is not in the table below. तो क्या टेबल के अंदर कोई कमांड है? So this means he can run all the commands. Because permit any command that is not in the table below. So if you have specified something, he's not going to run it, but whatever that is not specified, he will able to run it. It's more like you are creating an access list of permit, IP, any. So,
table
mein
permit command. Table mein permit C command.
कहाँ? वो तो चलेंगी चलेंगी, जो आपने स्पेसिफाई नहीं की उसके साथ क्या करना है? So you haven't specified here anything. तो उसका क्या रूल होता है? Deny all commands. But here what I want is, I don't want कि implicit deny हो जाए. I want like at the end of the day permit IP any. So permit any command that is not in the table below. So he will allow all the commands technically. अगर आपने यहाँ पे show run भी define कर दिया, वो command भी allow होगी और ये भी कमांड होगी. और आई एम गोइंग टू से सो रूट मीन्स आई हैवंट डिफाइंड एनी कमांड, आई जस्ट सेड परमिट एनी कमांड दैट इज नॉट इन द टेबल बिलो. कि जो इसके अंदर नहीं उसके साथ क्या करना है? उसके साथ ये करना है कि उसको क्या कर दो, अलाउ. And these are the commands that I have defined. Now the last step is to bind your configuration, your group, your privilege, plus your command set. That is done through what? Access policies. Now device, default device admin authorization. Now here you are going to create the policies. इसमें दो चीज़ें, आइडेंटिटी, ऑथेंटिकेशन कहाँ से करना है? इंटरनल यूजर्स. अगर आपके यूजर्स यहाँ पे नहीं है, इट इज़ ऑन एडी सर्वर, यू कैन चेंज द डेटाबेस टू एडी सर्वर, वट एवर, बट राइट नाउ इट इज़ ऑन इंटरनल यूजर्स. सो जैसे ही आप करोगे तो आपको पॉलिसीज क्या पुश करनी है, दैट इज दिस थिंग, दिस इज द चार्ट. हियर यू आर गोइंग टू से वट क्रिएट, आई वॉन्ट टू क्रिएट ए रूल. दो रूल बनेंगे, एक फ्रेशर के लिए और एक किसके लिए? रूट के लिए. तो आपको ये सारे पैरामीटर फिल करने के लिए बोल रहा हूँ. आइडेंटिटी ग्रुप, वी हैव आइडेंटिटी ग्रुप, राइट? सबसे पहले फ्रेशर के लिए बनाते हैं. सो फ्रेशर एनडीजी लोकेशन, क्या हमने ऐसा कुछ बनाया? डिवाइस टाइप और कमांड सेट भी नहीं दिखा रहा वो तो, यस और नो? सो दिस मीन्स आई हैव टू customize this thing. He's asking unnecessary options, right? So let me cancel it, and here I have an option of customize. What particular option you are looking for? I'm looking for command sets also. He was asking just shell profile, right? But I want to include what? Command set. Don't ask him about NDG location, don't ask him about device type, don't ask him about date and time. Ask about group and ask me about protocols. The protocol is what? TechX plus. Okay. And now I'm going to say create. अब देखो ये चीजें चाहिए थी हमें. Identity group, fresher. Protocol. TechX plus. Shell profile. Fresher shell and the command set is fresher command set, and I'm going to say okay. अब पे एक रूल रेडी हो गया. Let's create one more rule. Create identity group root. Protocol TechX plus. So if the user is authenticated through which group? Root group, जिसके अंदर हमारा XYZ है. तो आप उसको क्या assign करो? Root shell. Plus you have to assign him a command set that is root command set. Okay, save changes. आपकी दो पॉलिसीज रेडी हो गई। इजी था ना? कोई डाउट है तो पूछो यहाँ तक, देन वी विल गो फर्दर। वेरिफिकेशन के नाम पे हम क्या कर लेते हैं, टेस्ट, ट्रिपल ए, ग्रुप, टेक एक्स, यूजर नेम सिस्को, पासवर्ड नहीं, क्या है यूजर नेम एबीसी, पासवर्ड एबीसी 123, और इट्स अ कर्टसी दैट यू हैव टू यूज लेगेसी और न्यू कोड, क्योंकि टेक एक्स के पास ऐसा कुछ नहीं, बट द कमांड वॉज डिजाइन समथिंग लाइक दिस, सो यूज एनीथिंग, इट डजेंट मैटर, सक्सेसफुली ऑथेंटिकेट, एंड द लास्ट वन वॉज एक्स वाई जेड, is that 123, user was successfully authenticated. Let's start with the main thing. Debug TechX, debug AAA authentication, debug AAA authorization, and let's telnet R2. He's asking a username, username ABC, password ABC123. तो बता भी रहा आपको, एक मेथड लिस्ट पिक किया, कौन सी, माई ऑथ। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू सेंड अ पैकेट टू दिस थिंग, यहां पे आपको एक दिखाई देगा, ऑथेंटिकेशन रिक्वेस्ट इज फॉरवर्डेड, ये रहा एग्जैक्ट, एज सून एज द ऑथेंटिकेशन इज पास, बिकॉज द ट्रिपल ए सर्वर इज गोइंग टू से दैट ऑथेंटिकेशन इज परफेक्ट, नाउ इज गोइंग टू क्रिएट अ पैकेट एंड आस्किंग हिम वट प्रिवलेज लेवल आई शुड असाइन। यहाँ पे बता भी रहा है शेल प्रिवलेज लेवल फॉर वॉट, बिकॉज आई एम गोइंग टू गिव हिम कमांड लाइन इंटरफेस CMD, सो ही सेंडिंग अ रिक्वेस्ट फॉर विच यूजर ABC, सो आई एम गोइंग टू एलोकेट ए प्रिवलेज लेवल, सो प्लीज टेल मी वट शुड बी द प्रिवलेज लेवल, एंड द रिटर्न इज गोइंग टू टेल हिम दैट असाइन प्रिवलेज लेवल 1, सो दैट इज द स्कोप ऑफ ऑथराइजेशन एग्जेक for asking about the privilege level, that's why you get privilege level 1. So privilege, aapne command chalaiye kaun si, show privilege, authorization ka ek packet banega, he's going to create one packet, in that thing he's going to say there is a user whose name is ABC. TTY means that he is hitting on line VTY, he is hitting with this IP address, so I want to ask him whether the user is authorized to run the command show privilege or not. He is sending the packet to the TechX server, in return he is getting a reply of pass that yes he is able to run that command. Now I'm going to type enable, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So that I can land in privilege level 10. But the thing is, I haven't enabled authentication. I have to say AAA authentication for what? Enable. कि जब आप कोई enable password prompt करे तो आपको वो password कहाँ भेजना है? Whether you have to check that enable password locally or you should forward it to the AAA server. So AAA authentication enable. अब हमारे पास दो मेथड होते थे, नेम्ड और डिफॉल्ट, बट यहां पे एक ही ऑप्शन है डिफॉल्ट। अब क्वेश्चन आता है इसमें एक ही ऑप्शन क्यों है, देखो सपोज दिस इज अ रूम, ठीक है, यहां पे तीन बॉक्स गेट है, गेट 1, गेट 2, गेट 3, The user A has been entering through this gate. B यहाँ से आ रहा है, C यहाँ से आ रहा है, D यहाँ से आया, E यहाँ से आया, F यहाँ से आया. Now I told you to make a database that okay, which user is coming through which gate. तो आपने यहाँ पे आपने monitor किया और यहाँ से आप देख रहे थे A को भी, gate number 2 को भी और gate number 3 को भी. And you have made the database that on gate number A, sorry gate number 1, the user is A and B, sorry A and D. On gate number 2, the user is E and B. And gate number 3, the user is C and ठीक है. ये तो इजी था. Now I change the situation. Now I said you have to identify the user, but the user is already inside the room. A, B, C, D, E, F. अब आपको identify करना कौन सा user कौन से gate से आया था. क्या आप identify कर सकते हो? मैंने आपको एक डेटाबेस बना के दे दिया कि आप मुझे आइडेंटिफाई करके बताओ कौन सा यूजर किस गेट से आया था. एंड द यूजर्स आर ऑलरेडी इनसाइड द रूम. अभी तो क्या था, ये तीन डोर है, 1, 2 and 3. आपने मॉनिटर कर लिया कि ए इससे आया था, बी उससे आया था, सी इससे आया था. बट अब यूजर क्लास में बैठ चुके हैं और अब आपको मॉनिटर करना है कि कौन सा यूजर कहाँ से आया था. विल यू एबल टू फाइंड आउट दैट? नो. सेम इन द केस ऑफ इनेबल. You already took the access of the box. आपने already क्या ले लिया device का access. Now the router is not able to find out whether the enable request is coming from a remote session or through console. क्योंकि आप तो already device का access ले चुके. You have already took the access of the box. That's why we have a default. क्योंकि आप room के अंदर आ चुके हो. Now I'm not sure that whether you use gate number 1, 2 or 3 because you have already entered in the room. But in the case of authentication, I'm able to find out whether you are coming from gate number 1, 2 or 3. So that's why we have what? Only default. That the user has already took the access. आपने देखो, यहाँ पे access लिया हुआ है. You are accessing the box. अब इसको देख के आप बता सकते हो कि क्या मैंने telnet लिया हुआ है या SSH लिया हुआ है या कंसोल लिया हुआ है या ऑक्सपोर्ट लिया हुआ है. नहीं पता आपको, बिकॉज एट द एंड ऑफ द डे आई एम एक्सेसिंग व्हाट? CLI. सेम विद द केस ऑफ दिस थिंग कि यूजर ऑलरेडी रूम में है तो अब आप फाइंड आउट नहीं कर सकते. सो आई कैन नॉट अप्लाई इनेबल ऑथेंटिकेशन ऑन VTY और कंसोल. आई हैव टू यूज ग्रुप टेक्स. Now we have to type which keyword? Enable. कौन सा enable level? Command authorization field. So he has created a packet. Username ABC. Shell means CLI and he's typing what? Enable with the privilege level of 10. Please check whether the user is authorized to run the command or not. So now he's going to check. Okay, user ABC. User ABC belongs to which group? Fresher. Let me check my fresher command sets. Do the user have access of typing enable? Enable, 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 enable. No, there is no access. Now he is going to tell the router authorization status fail. Don't allow the user to run that command. And he said command authorization failed. So I have to go here and I have to manually say the user can type enable, submit, and now I can type the enable. Password is enable. Which privilege level? And I got privilege level 10.
We don't specify enable 10.
If you are not going to specify enable, without any number is going to take enable 15. Jaise aap agar, kya maine abhi kuch specify kiya? ये तो इस पर ऑथेंटिकेशन चला हुआ हो गए लॉक. नहीं नहीं, अगर मैं नॉर्मली CLI एक्सेस की बात करता हूँ. नहीं नहीं, आप जो पैकेट बना के भेज रहे हो वो किसका भेज रहे हो? इनेबल 10 का, क्योंकि मुझे मेक श्योर करना यूज़र किस पे जाए. इनेबल 10 पे. अगर आप यहाँ पे 15 लिखोगे तो वो जो पैकेट बनाएगा उसमें लिख के भेजेगा कि यूज़र क्या एक्सेस करना चाहता है, इनेबल 15 ये लिख के देखो, इनेबल 10। तो मैंने आपको कितना प्रिविलेज दिया हुआ है 10 का, आपने अगर डायरेक्ट इनेबल एंटर मार दिया तो मैं आप क्या मांग रहे हो, आप प्रिविलेज लेवल 15 मांग रहे हो आप ऐसे, बिकॉज इफ़ यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू स्पेसिफाई एनी थिंग इज गोइंग टू टेक बाई डिफॉल्ट प्रिविलेज लेवल 15। हाँ, अगर इफ़ यू हैव इट लाइक डिसेबल, डिसेबल कमांड का एक्सेस नहीं है, सो लेट्स एग्जिट, एग्जिट कमांड भी नहीं हमने दी थी, तो लेट्स गो अगेन। लेट्स गिव इट एग्जिट, सबमिट। आप चला तो कितनी भी कमांड सकते हो, इट्स अप टू यू, आप इनेबल अगर आप जो भी प्रिविलेज देना है यू कैन गिव इट। एक बार वो देखो, इन यहाँ पे CLI मेरा लॉक हो चुका है, क्यों, क्योंकि मैंने इनेबल ठीक है। नाउ द नेक्स्ट यूजर वाज कौन, द नेक्स्ट यूजर इज रूट, राइट, यूजर नेम XYZ, द पासवर्ड इज वॉट XYZ 123, गलत हो गया क्या, XYZ 123, इनेबल, दिस मीन्स आई वॉन्ट टू गो टू प्रिविलेज लेवल 15 एंड द पासवर्ड इज इनेबल, नाउ ही इज गिविंग मी द एक्सेस ऑफ प्रिविलेज लेवल 15। Yep.
How would user know that which privilege level he has to go? User would not have that information.
We are going to give him the information that you belongs to which privilege level actually.
Okay.
Because we have to tell him that you belongs to this privilege, because he can run the command show privilege to find out what is actually privilege level. We are giving someone authority actually. So we are going to
talking about where you specified, in front of enable you specified 10. Suppose I am a user and I'm trying to access. Of course, I would not be knowing the previous level, so I would end up getting...
Before giving you the access, I'm going to tell you that this is your username, this is your password, and this is your privilege level where you should work. It's more like this thing. Whenever I'm going to create your account, suppose you're joining my company as a fresher, and I'm going to create a username password for you first, right? So username ABC, your username Cisco, password is Cisco. And then I'm going to tell you that, okay, my friend, you are fresher, so I'm going to give you a privilege level of maybe 5. And the commands that you can run is all the show commands, because I'm going to tell you. Because if I'm not going to tell you, you will be confused which commands are there or not. Because you can run any command, EIGRP, OSPF. So I'm going to specify your job role. Your job role is to get privilege level 5 and you can run all the show commands. Plus you can run router EIGRP. Plus you can run router OSP. If I'm not going to specify your job role, you will be confused. Maybe you are going to check your interface. It is not working.
Okay, so you're trying to say administrator would tell that user that
every time
is 10 and make sure you use 10 in front of enable.
Yep. Every time, whenever you are going to access it, and these are the commands that you are going to run. If I'm not going to tell you, there are thousands of commands. How can you try each and every command?
So, sir, it's like every time a new employee is coming to the company, you have to update the server accordingly.
According to his roles, actually.
Yes.
Suppose in my company, NB, we have 3 roles. Privilege level, most of the company, 99% of the company that I have worked with, they have privilege level 1 or privilege level 50, mostly. Because creating a privilege level is going to give you lot of headache. It's more like complexity. So they will give you either show access, all the show commands access, or they are going to give you configure commands access. As per as industry, they don't want complexity by creating privilege level between 2 to 40. And if you are at L2 or L3, if you are at L3, you will get privilege level 15, and if you are at L1, you will get the show commands. or maybe I can give you the access of a switch, not a router, because a router is a routing device. But most of the time in the company, they don't create privilege level 2 to 14 because it will provide complexity in the network. But yes, Cisco is giving options, so we have to go through this thing. So now my task was that show privilege. Yep, I can access it. Suppose I don't want to allow him command root. This was my root user. Permit all command, but I don't want that he can run show let's say IP protocol. I don't want that he can run show IP protocol. So I can say deny show IP protocol. Add. Before adding it, let me make sure he can run this command. Show IP protocols. Actually, it is protocols. So edit protocols, add. This one I want to delete. So I want to deny show IP protocols. And I will say submit. And this time the command authorization is failed. So it's up to me what particular command I want to run. Because in the concept of normal privilege level that we have gone through is the inheritance rule was the big problem. If you are at privilege level 5, you can run all these 3, 4, 2, 1. Plus command authorization was not there. That I cannot, if I'm saying show, all the show commands will be there. If I'm saying router EIGRP, the user can run router OSPF also, right? But here it's up to me which command I want to specify. So that is the best part. Now, what if I want to deny this thing? Router OSPF. So deny router OSPF. Deny router OSPF. So will I able to type router OSPF or not? Will this command is going to run or not? Ye to chal gayi. The behavior of the box is you have to run extra command for the authorization, that is AAA authorization config commands. By default, the authorization of configuration level command is disabled. So you have to type one more extra command, AAA authorization of configuration level commands. And now it will start creating authorization for configuration level commands. And now if you are going to type router OSPF1, this command is not going to work. But now you can type router EIGRP1, this command will work. This thing is clear. So to perform the authorization of configuration level commands, you have to type this command AAA authorization config commands. Accounting में किस यूजर ने क्या कमांड चलाई अकाउंटिंग में कीपिंग ट्रैक ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी यूजर.
हाँ
शो आईपी इंटरफेस ब्रीफ. शो रन सेक्शन उसमें तो आप शो रनिंग देखोगे ना. शो आईपी इंटरफेस ब्रीफ कैसे देखोगे. Show IP interface brief or show run section IP is different. Both are different concept. यहाँ से और यहाँ से अलग है ना. Show run से मतलब क्या होगा आपकी running configuration. Show run command privilege level 15 की command है, not privilege level 1. अगर आपको नहीं देना तो आप हटा सकते हो. बट दीज आर बोथ डिफरेंट कमांड. शो आई पी इंटरफेस ब्रीफ अलग कमांड है. शो रन सेक्शन आई पी इज डिफरेंट. और कोई डाउट? बट क्या उसके पास प्रिविलेज लेवल 15 का पासवर्ड होगा? जैसे कि मैंने कहा इनेबल पासवर्ड सिस्को, डिड आई डिफाइन एनी प्रिविलेज लेवल लाइक इनेबल? बिकॉज आई कैन, आई हैव अ ऑप्शन ऑफ इनेबल पासवर्ड लेवल दैट आई वांट टू सेट इनेबल पासवर्ड फॉर विच लेवल, आई हैवंट डिफाइन इट राइट, आई जस्ट सेट इनेबल पासवर्ड सिस्को. If I am not defining any kind of privilege level, it is going to take privilege level 15. अगर आप privilege level define नहीं कर रहे हो, वो कितना लेगा? 15. If you are specifying it, you can specify that if a user is going to type for 10, the password is Cisco. For secret use कर लेना अगली बार से. 11, the password is Cisco 11. For 12, the password is Cisco. So I'm defining enable password for different security level. So this is for privilege level 10, this is for 11, this is for privilege level 12. And if you are not defining it, this means it is privilege level 15. Now suppose rather than using a router, I want to use a switch for authorization. अब स्विच के लिए क्या करना होगा? सपोज आई वांट टू परफॉर्म ऑथराइजेशन ऑन द स्विच बिकॉज वी हैव राउटर एंड स्विच. लेट्स सी वेदर द कमांड्स आर डिफरेंट और नॉट ऑन द स्विच एंड लेट मी रीसेट माय एसीएस कॉन्फ़िगरेशन सो दैट वी कैन रिवाइज वन मोर टाइम व्हाट एक्चुअली वी हैव टू कॉन्फ़िगर ऑन एसीएस. So I'm just going to restart the ACS just to make sure we will revise it again. But we will follow the same approach. ABC, XYZ, privilege 110, privilege 115, and these are the commands. Running or not? Yep. So let's access the rack. So I'm going to use this rack for up to np show host. Right now in this rack I have 6 router, 1 intrusion prevention device, I have 3 firewalls, 1 wireless LAN controller, 1 access point, and I have 3 switches. This one is of 3700 series, this one is also 3700, and this is 3500 series. So I'm going to use this rack up to CCNP. Maybe in CCI I'm going to use this one or the CCI rack. So now I'm going to make a small topology, something like this. R1, switch 1, and this is my ACS that is running on my PC. That is 192.168.1.50. So I'm going to do what? I'm going to go to switch and I'm going to create a SVI. I think aap sabhi ko aata hoga SVI and all that. SVI of VLAN 192, and I'm going to say 192.168.1. So first let me provide a connectivity between switch 1 and ACS. Okay, So let's say switch one. जो आप पूछ रहे थे ऑटो सिक्योर, ये रहा इनिशियल कॉन्फ़िगरेशन डायलॉग। नाउ सो फर्स्ट आई हैव टू मेक श्योर माय एसीएस शुड बी कनेक्टेड टू विच इंटरफेस। सो आई एम गोइंग टू जस्ट अनप्लग। So my ACS has been connected to port number 7. So this port is F1/0/7. This is my port number. So I'm going to say port number 7 belongs to VLAN 192, right? And I'm going to create a SVI. IP address 192.168.1.1. Then, so now I have successfully created a SVI of 192.168.1.1. The next task, what you are going to do is you are going to bridge your traffic. This is your PC. Technically, this is what? A PC. And inside the PC, you are running ACS. Now my PC has been connected through two modes. The first mode is through a LAN cable. Through a LAN cable. The second mode of connectivity is wireless. So I need to make sure I'm going to send my all ACS traffic through what? Wired or wireless?
Wired.
So for that I have to perform bridge. Bridge is to define the mode where you are going to send the traffic. Bridging is going to define through which NIC you are going to send the traffic. Either you want to send it through wired or you want to send it through wireless. So what I'm going to do is I will go to this thing. I will say edit virtual network editor. I have to create a virtual switch. In virtual switch, I am going to bind it with NIC card. What I am going to do is, I am going to create a virtual switch. And I am going to bind the virtual switch with the NIC card plus the ACS. So suppose this is the NIC card of the PC. I am going to bind my virtual switch with the NIC card and with the ACS. So I have a by default. I will say change settings. Yes, VMnet 0, that is bridge. You have different option of bridge. You can send it through wireless, that is Wi-Fi. These are both Wi-Fi and this is my LAN cable, Realtek PCI. This is my LAN adapter. So I want to send it through LAN. So I'm going to say Realtek PCI and this is my virtual switch 0. And you are going to say okay. Then now let me assign that VM0 to this ACS. Now you are a part of VM0. Now let me try to ping it. Ping 192.168.1.50. I'm not able to ping it. Ho gaya, chalo, achha. But if you are not able to ping it, you can disable your firewall. If you are not able to ping it, just disable your firewall. And let me ping it from my VMware also. Ping 192.168.1. Ping IP actually. Ping IP. पहले खुद को ping करो. Ping and then switch. Ping. So I have a complete reachability between a switch and the ACS. Now let me tell you, if you are going to access our CCNP security racks or maybe CCI, you are going to see some kind of topology. So the physical topology of our rack will be this thing, even this one. We have two switches. Isme teen hai, mereko ek zarurat thi. In CCNP rack, you are going to find out two switches, switch 1 and switch 2. Switch 1 is of 3750 series and switch 2 will be of 3550. Each rack has 5 routers, R1, R2, R3, R4, R5. And these are connected to switch 1. वैसे आप सबको पता है या नहीं पता? Physical, नहीं पता. So this will be R1, R2, R3, R4 and R5. All 0x0. क्योंकि मैं ब्रैक एक्सेस कर रहा था, मेरे को याद आया शायद मैंने आपको फिजिकल टोपोलॉजी नहीं बताई थी एनपी की. अब 0x0 तो कनेक्ट हो गई, अब क्या बचे? 0x1. R1, R2, same router. R3, R4, R5. And but now the port has been changed, 0x1, 0x1. Switch ke connected hai ye 0x1 se, 0x2 se, 0x3 se, 0x. ठीक है, जब हम फायरवॉल पढ़ेंगे तो मैं आपको आगे फायरवॉल बता दूंगा कि फायरवॉल किसे कनेक्ट. अभी तो हम लेयर 3 सिक्योरिटी कर रहे हैं. लेयर 3 मींस आई एम गोइंग टू ओनली टॉक अबाउट राउटर्स और लेयर 3 स्विचेस. तो इस केस में मेरा लेयर 3 स्विच भी कनेक्ट हो गया और क्या हो गया? राउटर. इस रैक पे भी यही टोपोलॉजी है. सो व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू डू इज आई एम गोइंग टू क्रिएट अ टोपोलॉजी वेयर आई विल से router, switch and ACS. Zero by zero. ये किससे connect होगा? Switch one के 0x1 से. And this port has been connected to 7. 0x7. So I'm going to create IP here 192.168.1.2. On the switch, I have SVI of 192.168.1.1. And here it is running on 1.15. So by default on the switch, let's talk about AAA new model command. Disable. मैंने आपको बताया था router और switch पे disable होगी और firewall पे क्या होगी? Enable. So AAA new model. As soon as you are going to type AAA new model, it will start asking a username and password. AAA Authentication, login, my authent group, techx, AAA, authorization, exec, my exec group. और जो आप पूछ रहे थे कि अगर authentication successful हो गया और authorization के time पे केवल या connectivity चली गई, then I can say You can assign locally by defining privilege level 1 कि if authenticated. ये actually हमारी lab में आता है question. क्या lab web कर ली थी क्या आपने? ये हमारी CCA lab का question है कि connectivity down हो जाए what you are going to do. So for authorization you have to type the keyword if authenticated. तो वो locally भी आपको access दे देगा. But right now it is CCNA, so I'm just talk about this thing. Login. AAA authorization exec, my exec group techex. AAA authorization command 0, my command group techex 1, and again for कोई चीज है commands में नहीं, सारी commands वैसी है. Then AAA authentication enable. इस बार enable हटा देते हैं, normal करके देखते हैं पहले. Then I have to apply on what line? B device 0 to 4, login, authentication. My authorization exec my exe authorization commands 0 my command 1, and the last one is do show history. Same, कोई कुछ अलग नहीं है, कोई नई command नहीं चलाई अभी तक. The last one is check server host 192.168.1.50 keys what Cisco. अब आप मुझे बताओगे कैसे कॉन्फ़िगरेशन करनी है फॉर दिस थिंग. सो फर्स्ट आई हैव टू टेक द जीयूआई एसीएस एडमिन और डिफॉल्ट होगा डिफॉल्ट सीसीआई सेक 1 2 3 ठीक है. सबसे पहले किस में जाना है? नेटवर्क रिसोर्सेज AAA क्लाइंट. यहां पे क्या ऐड करना है? स्विच 192.168.1.1. आई वांट टू यूज रेडियस सॉरी टेकएक्स एंड द की इज व्हाट सबमिट. The next user and identity stores. Here I am going to create first identity groups. अगर आप identity group ना भी बनाना चाहो, no problem at all. Let me tell you how you are going to do it. If you don't want to use the concept of group, आप नहीं चाहते नहीं हमने तो नहीं बनाना group. ठीक है आप मत बनाओ, no problem at all. Let's create normal users. Users तो बनाओगे. ठीक है, सो लेट्स क्रिएट अ यूजर. यूजर नेम एबीसी, पासवर्ड इज ABC123 ABC123. दिस टाइम आई एम नॉट यूजिंग इनेबल ऑथेंटिकेशन, जस्ट नॉर्मल ऑथेंटिकेशन. सो वन यूजर दिस वन, एंड आई हैव अनदर यूजर XYZ123 सबमिट. This time I'm not using the concept of group. Okay, now the next step what we are going to do is we are going to say policy element. We have to define some kind of privilege level. Shell profile to define the what privilege level. So I'm going to say the shell is for ABC shell. And common task I want to perform is default privilege level. I want to assign him privilege level 10 directly. Not from 1 to 10, I want to assign him directly privilege level 10. And the maximum privilege level is remain always 10. We cannot go further privilege level 10, and I'm going to say 15. Create. The next profile is for XYZ. XYZ shell. Common task. The default privilege level I want to assign is 15. As soon as the user is going to log in, he will get privilege level 15. Static, and he will always remain in 15. Maximum. Done. So I have defined the privilege level. The next step is to define what? Command sets. I'm going to say ABC command. ABC is what? A fresher. So he can run all the show commands. Just show commands, okay. Just to make it really, really simple, then we will make it complex. And the root user can run, that is XYZ, he can run all the commands. And the last step will be what? Mining. So, authorization, device administration, so I'm going to say authorization. I'm going to say what? He's going to ask me unnecessary information, right? In this time, I don't have this thing, so I'm going to, rather than using this thing, I will say customize. I need command set? Yes. I don't need anything? Remove. Now, I have to assign a privilege level. Last time, I was assigning the privilege level based on group, right? Last time, I'm saying if the user belongs to this group, I want to give him this privilege. But this time, I'm not creating a group, so the option will be of user name. Rather than using the concept of group this time, I'm just assigning username. That if username is ABC, this is the privilege level, this is the command set. If the username is XYZ, this is the privilege level, this is the command set and the protocol. Okay, and create. System name, username, the username is ABC. The protocol that I'm going to use is TechX. If the user is ABC, I will give him ABC shell. And the commands I'm going to give him ABC command. Okay. Save changes. One more. So I'm going to say create. System name is what? XYZ. The protocol that I'm going to use is TechX. Shell I'm going to use is XYZ shell. And the command is going to use is okay. Save changes. Let's enable the Wireshark so that we can capture the packets and find out what is actually going on in the terms of authorization. Ethernet. And I'm going to capture only TechX packet. Done. Now the first step is AAA group TechX ABC ABC 123 legacy. User was successfully authenticated. TechX ka filter hi nahi chal raha. This is TechX. So authentication query, authentication response. Now let's start the process. Let me take access of router R1. Based on our topology, the R1 IP address will be 192.168.1.2. देखो अच्छा सा इंटरनेट भी चल रहा है इसके अंदर. पिंग www. ठीक है, बट हमें इंटरनेट नहीं चलाना, हमने तो F0/0 पे IPS इंटरनेट 192.168.1.2. नो and I have to send this router interface to the same VLAN 192. ये आपने पढ़ा होगा CCNA में VLAN and all that. So now let's ping it, ping 192.168.1.1. Yep, I can access 1.1. Telnet 192.168.1.1. Username ABC. Password ABC123. I got the access. I should get a privilege level of 10. The packets that I'm going to see is regex query decrypted and is sending a packet of authorization that a user tried to type a command in the shell, means in the CLI is typing a command show privilege. So is the user is authorized to run that command, but which user? I have three users, so he's going to send the user ABC. The user ABC tried to run this command because on ACS we have hundreds of users. So if you are going to say there is a user who wants to type a command show privilege, so should I allow that command or not? ACS say which user, then is going to send a packet user ABC. This is the IP address of the user, this is the name of the user, and this user wants to type show privilege user ABC. So he's going to check his access policies that ABC will able to run ABC command set. Abhi hit count kitna dikha raha hai? Actually the problem is he is going to refresh it every 15 minutes. Hit counts are collected every, but we want it manually. So kitne aa gaye? 4. But there is zero hit count with this because we haven't used XYZ. So this is how a authorization packet is created. So whenever you are going to type any of the command, suppose you are typing show IP interface bit, the switch is going to create a packet. He's going to say there is a user ABC. He's typing a command show IP interface brief. So is the user is allowed or not? And then the regex server is going to reply yes, the user is allowed. No, the user is not allowed. That is response packet. So this is R means response. In this thing, he's going to inform the switch whether it is pass or whether it is fail. For example, let me type configure terminal or yahan pe command authorization fail nahi aa raha. The key point that I want to show you is this thing. I'm not getting command authorization failed. And if you are going to see Wireshark, none of the packet is forwarded. Agar aap yahan pe Wireshark pe bhi dekhoge, the last packet is of techx. ये सारा जी वाई दिखा रहा है, वो एक्चुअली जो आप जी वाई एक्सेस ले रहे हो वो सारे पैकेट्स हैं. द लास्ट पैकेट वाज दिस वन जो शो प्रिविलेज पे चलाया था. इवन द राउटर इज नॉट जनरेटिंग एनी काइंड ऑफ पैकेट फॉर दिस थिंग डिबग टेक एक्स. ये कमांड चलाई आपने शो प्रिविलेज, टेकएक्स का पैकेट बना, फॉरवर्ड किया, रिप्लाई आया पास एंड आई गॉट द आउटपुट ऑफ 10. बट इफ आई एम टाइपिंग शो रन, कोई पैकेट नहीं बना. this is the key point that I want to explain to you. That's why I use so simple of configuration. Configuration maine simple rakhi hai just to make sure you will be good in this concept. Iske liye ek aur router lete hai. आपने पढ़ा था फ्राइडे को प्रिविलेज होते हैं 0 टू 50, 0, 1 एंड 50 ने सिस्टम डिफाइंड, राइट? सिस्टम जो डिफाइन करता होता है 0, 1 एंड 50. कुछ कमांड्स होती हैं 0 में, कुछ 1 में, कुछ किस में होती है 15 में, राइट? शो प्रिविलेज, दिस इज प्रिविलेज लेवल 1. शो प्रिविलेज, दिस इज प्रिविलेज लेवल. Show IP interface brief. So show IP interface brief is a part of which privilege level? Showrun is the command that is not part of privilege level 1, because showrun means you're all running configuration. Showrun is a part of privilege level 15. Now the router is, the switch is thinking something like this, that the user is typing showrun. I'm not going to create any kind of X packet. Why should I create? Because showrun is a part of privilege level 15 and the user is at currently level. So why should I send that packet to ACS server? Because the user is already a part of privilege level 10. So there is no sense of sending that command to ACS server. I'm going to drop the packet on my end, not on my ACS. Because the ACS told you that the user belongs to what privilege level? 10. And show run is the part of privilege level. Show run is the part of privilege level 15. So there is no sense of sending this authorization request to ACS server. So it's going to drop the packet on its own end, not on the ACS. So that's why you are not able to see command authorization failed. Command authorization fail will be shown when the ACS is going to drop the packet. Here you are going to see invalid command. He's saying you are not authorized to run the command of show run. Actually, the show run is a technically part of privilege level 15. So why should I give you the access of 10? The switch is thinking like this. Now, how to tackle this problem? The answer is quite simple. You have to give him privilege level 15 access. And there you can restrict the user. There is no sense of defining privilege level 2 to 14. You can restrict the commands by privilege level 1 and 15. Even though user is at privilege level 15, I want to give him only show commands plus show run also. There is no sense of restricting the user to privilege level 2 to 14. That's why in industry you don't have custom privilege level. They are using privilege level 15, but they are restricting the users on privilege level 15. How? Something like this. Policy element, shell profile, ABC shell. Why you are defining 10? Define 15. Why you are worry about privilege level when you are defining the command sets? Why you are thinking about a privilege level? So define privilege level 15. Why? Because you already defined what particular command the user can run. So don't look at the privilege level. Let it be 15. Assign the commands that the user can run only these commands. So now let me take the session off. Ab authorization fail hoga because exit is a privilege level 1 command. So I have to give exit. Exit. Now when you are going to telnet ABC 1, 2, 3, show privilege. You are landing in privilege level 15, but you can run all the show commands, no problem at all, but you cannot type configure terminal. That's why in the industry they are giving you privilege level 1 or privilege level 15. Why to define 2 to 14 when you can restrict the user at privilege level 15? Iska kya fayda hua command set ka agar aap privilege level khel rahe ho to? So that's why you always define privilege level 15 और उसमें आप command को क्या कर सकते हो? Restrict. Command authorization fail. If you want to give this command, ABC command set, कौन, हाँ सपोज मैंने रॉन्ग कमांड दे दी, मैंने दे दिया कुछ भी, स्पेलिंग मिस्टेक हो गई मेरे से, कॉन्फिगर टर्मिनल की एंड आई सेड सबमिट, कमांड ऑथराइजेशन फेल. देन यू विल थिंक यार कमांड तो मैंने ठीक दी थी. सो दैट्स व्हाई आई विल रिकमेंड यू इन द लैब ऑल्सो, प्लीज इस पे थोड़ा सा ज्यादा ध्यान देना. मैंने अपनी लैब में बिल्कुल अच्छे से चार बार चेक की थी, क्योंकि ये चीज़ें ऐसी है कि पता ही नहीं चलती, उतना प्रेशर रहता है उस टाइम, क्योंकि दिस इज़ द लास्ट सेक्शन ऑफ द लैब, ACS इज़ द लास्ट सेक्शन, कि 6.1 इज़ द ACS सेक्शन. तो उस टाइम आप इतने थक जाते हो, एग्जॉस्ट हो जाते हो पूरी लैब को करते करते, ही हो सकती है मिस्टेक्स. सो मेक श्योर लैब सेक्शन 6.1 में आप इजीली करो, और रेदर देन यूजिंग दिस थिंग आप CLI हेल्प लो by typing configure terminal. क्योंकि आखिरी के टाइम में अगर कोई टी शूट आ जाए ना, फिर वो होता नहीं है. अगर आपके पास 20 मिनट बचे एंड स्टिल ऑथराइजेशन इज नॉट वर्किंग, तो वो आपके ऊपर प्रेशर बनने लग जाएगा एंड मे बी आप उसको फाइंड आउट ना कर पाओ, कि इतनी सिली मिस्टेक भी हो सकती है. सो दैट्स व्हाई आई विल रिकमेंड टू यूज CLI, configure वहाँ से पेस्ट करो, टर्मिनल वहाँ से पेस्ट करो. सो नाउ I can type configure terminal. देखो मैं यहाँ पे कोई भी कमांड चला सकता हूँ, IP routing enable कर दी. I can run any command because by default command authorization is not enable. बताया था ना router पे command authorization enable नहीं होता. So I have to say AAA authorization config commands. Now I cannot run all these commands, not router EIGRP, not router OSPF. I want to give him access of router OSPF, so I'm going to go to command set, ABC commands, and I'm going to say router OSPF, add, submit, and now I can run router OSPF. And in the logs, you are always see pass. If your authorization response is fail, you are going to see fail. Even you can take help of, even if in the exam authorization is not working, authentication is working but your authorization is not working, always take help of monitoring and reports. Launch monitoring and report viewer. और यहाँ पे मुझे क्या चाहिए? Reports. So I'm again telling you, first click on launch monitoring and report viewer. हमें basically report चाहिए होगी. So I will get this option and from this thing I'm going to type what? Reports. And I will get reports. Welcome to ACS reports. Report में आपको क्या चाहिए? कौन सा protocol की report चाहिए? I want the TechX authorization. अभी कुछ नहीं दिखा रहा तो मैं कहूँगा लास्ट 30 मिनट्स की क्या करो, रिपोर्ट जनरेट करो. एंड इज गोइंग टू जनरेट ईच एंड एवरी रिपोर्ट. यूजर नेम ABC था, उसने कमांड चलाई राउटर OSPF पर, फेल्ड हो गई थी बिकॉज दैट टाइम ही वॉज नॉट ऑथराइज टू रन दैट कमांड. यूजर ABC, उसने कमांड चलाई राउटर OSPF पर, कॉन्फिगर टर्मिनल, कॉन्फिगर टर्मिनल, वाई द कमांड इज फेल्ड दिस वन. आप डिटेल व्यू जानना है तो आप इस पर क्लिक कर दो. अगर आपको डिटेल व्यू जानना है तो इस पेज पे आप क्लिक कर दो, क्लिक हेयर फॉर डिटेल रिपोर्ट एंड इट विल गिव यू द डिटेल रिपोर्ट अबाउट द यूजर्स. बट यहां से आपको पता चल जाएगा कमांड ऑथराइजेशन फेल, कमांड फेल टू मैच ए परमिट रूल. अब मुझे पता चल गया ठीक है, कमांड सेट में ये रूल परमिट नहीं है, राउटर OSPF इज नॉट परमिट इन द कमांड सेट. तो इसलिए शायद मैंने रॉन्ग कमांड टाइप किया, मे बी आई हैवंट गिवन द कमांड. सो फ्रॉम दिस थिंग आई कैन ट्रबल शूट माई क्वेरीज. तो यहां से आपको वो पता चलेगा. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट सम टाइम आउट्स. और कुछ होमवर्क भी करके लाना आपको. timeout. The first timeout is of authentication timeout. Authentication timeout होता है आपका 5 seconds का. Authentication timeout in the sense, if I am sending a packet to the ACS server, I am going to wait for 5 seconds until and unless if I haven't received any reply, I will consider him as dead. So if I am sending an access request packet, I am going to wait for only 5 seconds for his response. अब हम कैसे मान ले कि 5 second ही होता है? कैसे मान ले? तो हम चलते हैं exit, exit, exit. ठीक है, debug हमारे पास है, debug AAA authentication and debug techx. ठीक है, starting 5 seconds of timeout. I am sending a packet to a server 192.168.1.50 and I am going to wait for 5 seconds. Now, what if I want to change this timeout? Kya pata exam mein aapko bole ki the timeout should be of 10 seconds, the timeout should be of 4 seconds or 3 seconds, whatever. So for that you are going to say radius server host 192.168.1.50 and here you have an option of timeout, that you can define the timeout, that timeout is of 1 to 100 seconds. Aapki marzi aap kitna timeout define karoge. टेकएक्स का भी ऐसे ही होगा, दोनों का एक सेम होता है. अब बस टेकएक्स सर्वर लिख दो. एक ही बात है. ठीक है, सो दिस इज हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू चेंज द टाइमआउट. सेम इन द ऑथराइजेशन आल्सो, द टाइमआउट इज ऑफ दिस थिंग. ऑथेंटिकेशन एंड ऑथराइजेशन में टाइमआउट आपका 5 सेकंड होता है. दिस इज हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू चेंज इट. अब क्वेश्चन आता है दैट वी हैव गॉन थ्रू अ कंसेप्ट ऑफ पोर्ट नंबर्स ऑफ रेडियस. हमने कल रेडियस के साथ किया था एक प्रैक्टिकल, ऑथेंटिकेशन नॉट ऑथराइजेशन. वी हैव डन द ऑथेंटिकेशन पार्ट बट नॉट ऑथराइजेशन पार्ट. सो इन ऑथेंटिकेशन आई वाज रनिंग द कमांड रेडियस सर्वर होस्ट 192.168.1.50 की इसको यही चलाई थी. बट आई टोल्ड यू दैट ही कैन यूज लेगेसी पोर्ट नंबर प्लस और ही कैन यूज व्हाट न्यू कोड. लेगेसी में होता है मेरा पोर्ट नंबर 45 एंड न्यू में होता है 1812. आई हैवंट डिफाइन एनी काइंड ऑफ पोर्ट नंबर. क्या मैंने कुछ डिफाइन किया? सो इट इज ऑलवेज गोइंग टू टेक लेगेसी. If you are not defining the port number, it is always going to use legacy. हम कैसे मान ले? आप ऐसे मान लोगे इस कमांड से. Include radius. कितना ले लिया? 1645. How to change it? What if I want to, in the lab they are going to 100% change it to 1812. Because उनको पता है कि by default कितना जाता है? 1645. So in the lab you always use 1812. So this thing port 1812 and accounting port 1813. So this is how 200% they are going to give you the question to change the port number. 200% har lab mein hota hai question. Because this is legacy. Aap legacy technology ko kyon chala rahe ho jab aapko new code de diye gaye hain to. So in the lab they will tell you that the radius packet should be originate by 1812 and 1813. Even though they are not going to tell you you are not going to use 1645 at all. यार 1645 में प्रॉब्लम थी तभी तो वो 1812 पे आए, तो आप लैब में 1645 नहीं चला के आओगे. यू हैव टू मैनुअली डिफाइन द पोर्ट नंबर 1812 एंड 1813, चाहे क्वेश्चन में दिया हो या ना दिया हो. व्हेनेवर यू आर गोइंग टू डिफाइन द रेडियस सर्वर, यू आर ऑलवेज गोइंग टू डिफाइन पोर्ट नंबर 1812 एंड 1813. ठीक है, की से पहले अगर आपको टाइम आउट पूछा गया तो टाइम आउट 4 सेकेंड, की सिस्को डू शो हिस्ट्री. ठीक है, अभी तो ऑथेंटिकेशन पे भी ऑथराइजेशन पे भी आएंगे. दिस इज हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू डिफाइन द लोकेशन ऑफ दैट सर्वर एंड यू आर गोइंग टू डिफाइन द पोर्ट नंबर 1812 1813. एक और चीज, ये सबसे बड़ी गलती होती है हमसे. हम क्या करते हैं, आपने एग्जाम कर रहे थे, आपको आपने ये कमांड चलाई, ठीक है, आप लैब कर रहे थे, आपने ये कमांड चलाई, देन यू रियलाइज दैट ओके बाय डिफॉल्ट इज गोइंग टू टेक विच पोर्ट नंबर 1645 एंड 1646. देन आपने सडनली दोबारा कमांड चलाई और क्या डिफाइन कर दिया, 1812 एंड 1813. वो दोनों कमांड ले लेगा, यहाँ आप फंस जाओगे. नाउ इट डिपेंड अपॉन द स्विच, आइदर ही कैन सेंड द पैकेट विद 1645 और इट कैन सेंड 1812, इट्स अप टू दैट बॉक्स. नाउ यू हैव टू से नो एंड द प्रीवियस कमांड. तो लैब में भी आपको यही करना है दैट इफ यू आर गोइंग टू डिफाइन दिस थिंग एंड एक्सीडेंटली यू रियलाइज वो 1645 लेगा, फर्स्ट remove the previous command, don't go for the another command, remove the previous command and then give the new command. ठीक है, बाकी करेंगे कल, क्योंकि बच्चों की अभी PD क्लास भी है.